Viewers and subscribers, please subscribe to Saga News TV and give a like and share.
The Irrawaddy police have disclosed that 25-year-old Peter Johnson, who was on Monday fatally shot during a confrontation with members of the security force in Flanker St. James, was wanted by the police in the parish in connection to serious crimes, including murders and shooting. The disclosure was made by Assistant Commissioner of Police Clifford Chambers, who visited the scene after the shooting. He displayed a certain by resident of the community that Johnson was unarmed at the time of the shooting by the security force. Unfortunately, we had an incident at this Flanker location where a man challenged security personnel, and based on what the armed team is trained to do, they responded and the man was fatally shot. He was a person of interest and has been the subject of several joint police military operations for a period of time, said Chambers, and he was featured in several murders and shooting in the particular space here and the wider St. James Police Division. So the team executed what they were trained to do, and we are happy that things are back to normal now at the Chambers. Reports are that about 1:30 p.m. a joint police military team was summoned to the area where a man was said to have been spotted with guns. The man ran upon the approach of members of the security force, who give chase. Johnson reportedly opened gunfire at law enforcer, who fired back. Johnson was subsequently found suffering from gunshot wounds and was taken to Cornwall Regional Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. The Independent Commission of Investigation, INDICOM, had started a probe into the incident. A woman from the Papin Division said she cast her vote for the Jamaica Labour Party, JLP, on Monday after members of the party allegedly bought her 3 bags of chicken to assist with her upcoming fry fish event. Still, the woman who sport a green hat and green blouse said she is not a die-hearted Labourite, as she declared at the Better Party tell, "My reason for voting is because Labourite helped me. Me a keep me fish fry the 28th of this month, cause I want to put on my upstairs, and then buy me 3 bags of chicken, and a them me a vote for," she said. While being questioned about her political allegiance, the woman told reporters that if the opposition People's National Party managed to grant her more support for her upcoming event, she had no issue switching side. Would have just gone over to the PNP. Me na ask Christ at the Better Party tell. So if the PNP come now and buy me 4 bags of chicken, there's some thing there, she said, highlighting that after the election, support from politicians is not guaranteed. After this year, now see back nobody. If you're lucky to see them, God on your side. Bigger MP, Member of Parliament, than me a switch seat. So who is me? She questioned. Anybody a work for me, a them me a work with. The Papin Division is been contested by former PNP member Venetia Simit Phillips. Now, a member of the JLP is going up against the PNP, Darrington Ferguson. A severed human head was found by police along First Avenue in Greenwich Town, Kingston 13 on Sunday night. A video of the incident has since been posted on social media. Up to Monday afternoon, the body of the deceased had not yet been found. Reports reaching news indicated that around 9:30 p.m. the police received information that the human head was in a box at the location. A police team was dispatched to the community. Upon arrival, the team reportedly observed a red and navy carton box on the side containing a white bag in a blue plastic bucket, inside in which the human head was seen. The scene was processed and the head removed to the morgue. A man was shot dead along the New York's main road in Linstead, St. Catherine on Monday morning. The deceased has been identified as 55-year-old Renfold Paisley, a driver from Main Street in Bogwalk, St. Catherine. Reports are that about 9:30 a.m. residents of the New Works housing scheme heard loud explosion in the area and summoned the police. Lawman arrived at the scene and reportedly found Paisley body lying beside a gray Toyota Probox motor car near the New Works Pine Farm, suffering from what appeared to be gunshot wounds. He was assisted to the Linstead Hospital, where he succumbed to his injuries. No motive has been established for the killing, the police said. 45-year-old Clayton Robinson, a construction worker of Depot Drive, Gregory Park, St. Catherine, was arrested and charged following an incident at Nashville, Mandeville, Manchester between Wednesday, December 27, 2023 and Thursday, January 18, 2024. Robinson was charged with larceny of motor vehicle, uttering fraud documents, obtaining property by means of fraud documents, possession of fraud documents, and fraudulent use of license plate. Reports are that on Wednesday, December 27, 2023, Robinson rented a motor car from the complainant for a period of 7 days and was scheduled to return the vehicle on Wednesday, January 3, 2024. Reports are that he failed to return the vehicle on the contract date. A report was made at the Mandeville Police Station and an investigation was launched. On Sunday, February 18, Robinson was arrested by the police. The motor car was recovered and searched. A fraudulent driver's license with Robinson's information was found inside. He was charged